like 15 mile an hour. Like, I mean, you would move obviously, but it was so jerky. With the 800, it's such a smoother ride. I mean, I don't drive it all the time, but when I have, it is. I usually lead, but that gets boring after a while because I usually lead us in circles for some reason. Deep is this? Oh, I'm in shorts. I don't want to get muddy. Whatever. What's the point of coming four wheeling if you ain't gonna get muddy? Thank you. get in front of her and grab the front rack and stop her. And after that, we made sure to show her where the tail engine button or switch is. But yeah, that was a little scary. And I ended up, after all of like us getting the bike out of the cornfield or the soy field and everything, I ended up forgetting that I had left our littlest cousin in the treehouse, and I heard her crying. That's how we remembered, which is awful of me. But it wasn't that big of a treehouse. Like, she could, there's a slide that goes down and everything. She could have easily come down, but she saw an ant and it scared her, so that's what made her cry. But after that, you know, everything was all fine. But yeah, that was a while ago. Obviously, before we knew Elana had scoliosis. You know, I like, I mean, I know this isn't anything, obviously, but like rock climbing and stuff. Well, whatever you want to call it, I don't know. But, like, I really like that. There's a friend of mine who is part of an off-road club in college, and he goes out with his Jeep and does obviously much bigger rock stuff. But I think that's really cool. Like, I know it's like crazy dangerous, but I like that. Probably a really bad idea to switch gears now, but because he picks the best paths to go down. And this is when I like power steering. You catch a rut on this and it's gonna tip. All this like clay is real slick. You hit the brakes too hard and you're just gonna slide down either way. But you know, the engine brake on this thing still is amazing. Instead of goggles, it has that like pulled down thing, and I don't know if I like it. Like, I like the look of it, and it's convenient, like, but obviously it fogs up quick, but I can't hear. Like, I don't know if I'm just weird, but I need to hear when I ride. I need to hear, you know, what the motor sounds like, how hard everything's working, and when it's closed, I can't hear well, so I always ride it with it open. And like, I'll leave, you know, we'll leave here, well, on a dry day, and I'll have like dirt in a mark around my goggles. And I think it's kind of funny, which I probably should have something covering my eyes, but I only close them when I have to. Thank you. always be my baby. About following is anytime somebody in front of you goes through like a rut, they just dig it deeper.
Water from the pole start. I think
think it has a full start because it's not fuel injected. I don't know that much about quads, so why, but it had a full start. And the top where the rope was connected to that plastic bit, there would be water in there, and it would boil from how hot the motor got, and it would like spit on my leg. And we were just joking about that. That would hurt really bad. But you know, I kept going. Worth it. But this camera is probably like so, and my gloves aren't much help because they're so. There's like little lights in the fingers, so I don't know if they're gonna like burn out or something because I've never had them in the rain. It is like pouring. I don't know if you can see, but well, probably not. But it is like pouring. And I didn't bring a change of clothes like usual. So, hey, did you guys bring a change of clothes? I didn't. Not to PA. My visor still isn't closed though. Oh, let's not do that. I have shorts on and I'm already wet. No action today. Plus I get stuck in everything anyways. One of my dad's, I don't know if it's the first video, but it was an early one.
Ocean of a mud puddle, and I was rocking it back and forth.
not to anyone, so. But enough of my, like, diary stories.
Especially for dirt bikes, I'll watch to see how they jump and stuff.
because I am proud and determined to have one day. So, watch and learn, I guess. I like speed and I like jumps. And sometimes utility just doesn't do it for me. I used to want to race quads so bad. But then I realized, like, if you get a race quad, that's pretty much all you can do. Like, they can't do anything out here. I mean, they can, but it's such a hassle. Which, I don't know, I'd like to have, you know, a utility and then a dirt bike. Like, the best of both worlds kind of thing. But, working full time now. I mean, I'm only, like, I work in the kitchen at a restaurant and I, like, bus and seat people, but, full time is full time. So, gotta start saving somewhere, I guess. It's killing my thighs. deer?
That's a big bird. Look at it go.
Oh. Oh, I see it. It's like right there.
That was a big turkey. See it?
Yeah. Oh. It's like a little head was sticking out.
That was cool, huh?
Yeah. One guy my dad watches, I don't know his name. He, I think it's on the front of his bike, has a camera. He calls it like the bear cam or something. I don't think there's bears in this part of Pennsylvania. I could be wrong, I don't live here. But I think that's kind of cool. Like, I kind of would want to see a bear. Like, if we, or we're going back down to West Virginia at the end of this, I think August. And I think it'd be cool to see a bear, like, but not close up. Like, not like that turkey. Like, I don't know, maybe like a mile away would be okay with me. But just to get in on tape, you know, that would be cool. What? I'm kind of gonna miss this when I go to college. I did have this like crazy idea that I take dual credit classes through my high school, so I'm getting college credits for being in a high school class, you know, that's the whole dual thing. And I will have this crazy idea that I wanted to do a year at Kent. I mean, for anybody in Ohio, do a year at Kent, so my dual credits would apply because they don't apply out of state, and then after my year at Kent, go to some college in California, just because, you know, I want the weather. But, I know school doesn't have anything to do with four-wheeling, but whatever. I think I have decided that I would like to go to OU and major in psychology and minor in sociology. I just find Asperger's syndrome really intriguing, interesting, and everything. I mean, I'm not gonna go into it, but from the books I've read, like 8 books on it, but from the books I've read, like everything makes sense. Which I don't know if it's just me being weird, but I love it. It's a form to study it. Hold on, I know this. It's developmental psychology, I think. And I think that'd be really cool to eventually try and help understand, not help fix people or children with Asperger's, because I don't necessarily think it's a bad thing. But just to help further understand it, because I think it is the most interesting mindset and thought process. But yeah, a little about me, I guess, for anybody that cares, really. Drying off a little bit. battery before the mine. Or just stop videotaping, one of the two. Do you have the extra battery with you?
In the truck.
How much of this is left?
You should be fine for a while.
Okay, are you sure? I just want to know if I should stop videotaping and wait till the mine.
Yeah, you should probably.
All right. Right. Dad decided to go back to the truck again to get the other battery, so I don't have to stop videotaping. He likes me talking during these. I don't know why. I mean, I just feel like it's a bunch of nothing.
This is a little muddy.
Yeah.
That is car tracks, that is no four-wheeler track.
Right.
See that?
Yeah.
How did the car get out here?
Jane and I saw the truck.
Yeah, the power line guys we've seen out here, they work on the hill climbs, like, for, I don't know what company it is, but they'll come out here and play with the truck, and we followed them once. I don't know if I got it on video, it was one of the earlier videos, but, it was pretty cool. different exhaust or something. Like, Dad calls it a Looney Tunes. I don't know what it's really called, but makes it sound a lot louder. And I want that for a dirt bike. Like, I want it to be like screaming just because it sounds cool. I don't know, I try to like pay attention when he tries to tell me stuff about quads, but like sometimes it's just way over my head. Like, I don't know. I just learned about like the A-arm guards, like joint protectors, and I don't know. That's pretty much the newest thing I learned about. Remember, I thought I was so cool when we first started like getting parts for the quads, like getting the winch and everything. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so cool, I know about all this stuff. But there's so much I don't know about, and I'm not gonna like pretend. Oh, there's the truck. I knew it was little. But yeah, I'm not gonna try and pretend like I know what I'm talking about, because I know there's so much that I don't know. My little sister has on. It used to be mine. It was my very first helmet. Well, way back in the day, we used to wear like bike helmets, but like my first like DOT approved helmet. And I loved that thing. But Lena was playing with it one day and dropped it and busted the visor off. That's why there's like, I don't know if you saw it earlier, but there's electrical tape taping the visor on, because I was so mad. Like, I picked it out all by myself. I mean, it still fits me. I just wear this one because the GoPro mount is more centered on these helmets than it is on that one. But I love that thing. I'll never get rid of that. Video must kind of be boring, because I mean, all I've been videotaping is us getting halfway out to a trail and then turning around and coming back. But there's not a lot we can go through with Lena, and plus Dad isn't used to the new quad, like I've said a million times already. But I don't know. Like, and when I leave, Dad gets all mad because like I fly. I don't know. I just take off. And so I'll have to like throw in like the overdrive and reverse for like 2 hours to go find him again. So I just don't need anymore. Yeah, we passed out like 3 times. Out here, because we're the only ones that ride in pouring rain. Is it on? Is it on? Hey, is it on?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's on.
Okay.
Remember the baby one?
thought this one wasn't full charge when we left. And I want to have enough for the mine again. Just because Dad was, I don't know, videotaping it for a millionth time. Geocaching, for anyone who knows what that is. It's actually pretty cool. You should check it out. They have a website. Not promoting or anything. Like, I don't do that. But it's pretty cool. It's, there's some here, actually. We haven't gotten any just because we ride. But geocaching is, they get a little box and a log. And you put in the log, and then you can put, like, trade items or, like, coins and stuff. That you hide it somewhere that you're allowed to, obviously, and you go onto the website and you log in the like longitude and latitude, like the coordinates, and you can put, like, you know, like in the general area, then they'll get, like, the coordinates will get you so close to it, and then you have to find it. Like, it's hidden. Some people will, like, tape it in camo. Some people will hide it under leaves, in trees. And you find it, you open up, sign the log that you had found it. Like, there's some people that will sign it, like, their name, then, like, FTF, first to find, stuff like that. We used to do this all the time before we started four-wheeling, like, religiously. But, it was actually really cool. And I heard there was a couple here. I think Dad just forgot, to be honest. We haven't done it in a while. But definitely one of these times we should grab the coordinates, bring the GPS. us out and look for a couple, because I haven't found one in a while. We actually made, I forget what they're called, but they're like these little tags you can like verify on the geocache website, and like as you find them, you like you enter that you had found them, and then you can track where they go. Like one time we went to this Vickers Forest thing, and yes, I had worn Crocs, green Crocs, because those were cool back then, and I had stepped on a thorn bush, and a thorn maybe like 2 inches went through my shoe and into my foot. So I made a little geotag, or whatever it's called, called the Vickers shoe, and I had a little like a little bit bigger than a Barbie doll shoe, and I put the tag on it, and then I think now it's in like Germany or something. Like it'll send me emails to every time it gets a new destination. So it's been all over the US. It's been to Australia. But yeah, I think right now it's in Germany. And I mean, that's pretty cool. Like it started off in some little town in Ohio to across the oceans and stuff.
they grew mushrooms, just like all the stovetop mushroom mines. After they were done mining, the mushroom company came here and grew mushrooms for quite a few years. They was here until the mid-80s. And then they shut it down, and then sat here for a long time dormant, and Steve and Paul got the idea of Mines and Meadows, and I'm pretty sure this place has been running for about 12 years now. I've been here for about four, a little bit over maybe. Temperature in here stays 55 degrees year-round, never changes. I gather you guys are local.
Well, we're from by Alliance, Ohio. Sorry, no, we're a little ways away.
Yeah, you're not far. You're down here a lot?
Yep, we come down almost every weekend.
Oh, cool.
Yep.
Well, you just day ride or you camp or?
No, we just day ride. Because of work, we just, on my days off, we come out here. We love to ride, so.
Right. Well, I just tell everybody, I have a bunk house and a cabin on the side that I rent.
Oh, okay.
I have a cabin that sleeps four people comfortably. I rent it for $75 a night. It actually has a hot shower out back. And I also have a bunkhouse that has six bunk beds in it with a little kitchen area. Has a stove, or not a stove, but a refrigerator, microwave, a little sink to wash around. It's not drinkable water, but it's enough to wash up. It has a hot shower outside also. And I charge $100 a night for that one. But I just like to tell people that a lot of people don't know that we have that here, but it's convenient. You just want to go and spend one night, you know. It's there. As far as weekends, you don't permit me to rent it for just one night on a Friday or a Saturday. I have to rent it for two nights on the weekends. But on the weekends, open games. What else? I don't know. Was you guys here for any of the obstacles we had the last couple of years? Mudfest and...
No, haven't made it for that. We've done a couple things. We did the Easter egg thing, and then we did the poker run last time.
Oh, okay. Cool. Yeah, that was a dusty day, huh?
Oh, my gosh. That's the most people I've ever seen.
Yeah, that was a dust bowl over there.
Yep.
Yeah, they we do obstacle runs every year. This year, the only one I know is coming around so far this year is August 8th and 9th, Battle Frog is coming back.
Okay.
And Battle Frog was the Navy SEALs. They came in and set up a 5K and 15K obstacle course. They actually ran through the mine. They actually swam through our pond back here. They made them swim through the pond. So,
wow.
But they're here for the 8th and 9th. That's a good one to come watch them SEALs. Their whole idea is to make somebody quit. They was a lot of fun to set up with. I had a good time with the boys. It was fun. They'll be back here on the 8th and 9th of August. If you're interested, come watch people crawl through the mud.
We're going to be in Hatfield McCoy those days.
Oh, okay.
Head down south.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Nope.
But other than that, we go up over this hill with Barrett to the left a little bit. I'm sure John has told you, if I haven't been your guy, John was the other one, sure.
Mm-hmm.
But over here to the left a little bit, we'll go down around. I don't go through the lake at all. Johnny will take people through the outside of that lake once in a while. Right now, I'm not going through it. We just had a lot of rain the last few days. We'll go down and circle around. You see a guy in a boat fishing, and when you see the guy in the boat, you look down the hallway there. That's where all the rooms were, where we grew our mushrooms at, or where they grew their mushrooms at. And then we'll circle around and get back out in the daylight.
Cool.
Hopefully that rain's not let
I see how it's done.
I couldn't believe it. We come around that bend. I seen it coming.
I know. I'm like, we're almost there. We're almost there.
I know. That's why I sped up. I figured, let these guys
gloves. And, I mean, pretty much for anybody who watches this that rides, the blisters are real. Like, it is the struggle. Anybody else that rides here frequently, each time I come, which is almost like every week, it looks so different. Like the plants, everything grows so quickly. Because I started riding, well, we got our year passes on January 2nd, and since then, so much has changed. Like, it looks so different. I don't know, I feel like I sound like people I make fun of.
Those are some rough trails.
Yeah, thanks for the green paths.
The what?
The green paths.
Yeah, I know. You're going much easier than we are. We're bottoming out.
Your back end's popping up when you go down those hills. Those red arrows mean dirt bike. obviously no one pays attention to because these paths are so wide. But I don't think it matters that much. They're not too much dangerous, or too much more dangerous. My favorite, which I usually just stick to the right side, which I don't know if I want to go up today because it's so wet, but I probably will anyway.